Greetings, my name is Frozen, and today we're gonna continue Mega Maker, and I said continue again for some reason. We have very careful battle, okay. And we got the type of weapons I have grown to like. Oh, okay, I see. Wait a minute. This actually deflects the... Wait a minute, what? Did I do that? Huh. Wait, how long does this actually reach? Okay, the reach is actually pretty long. Okay. I seriously thought that it was almost like a melee weapon or something, but I guess not, so I just need to always be sure that he's not dodging it. Okay, oh, actually, I did it. Too bad that he glitches around a lot, so, yeah. He's really buggy. So, I don't know how you are careful in this. I would even call this like a oddly hectic fight more than really careful one, because, well, you know, like, I get the idea, but why do we need to have the, I mean, I guess we need to have this on both sides today. Yeah, the... He kind of just teleports into the air, so I guess I just need to only use the... When he's... Oh, no. Okay. Yeah, like it does that. After he's shot the grenade, I guess it's a safe time to attack. Okay. That's the one time when he actually stays put, and when he does that attack as well. Yeah. I mean, you can be careful. Yeah, but it's just... It jumps so fast that it's so difficult to predict, to be honest. Yeah, and it teleported again. It just keeps glitching around. Okay. So, when he starts doing those grenades, nope. They're only... Okay, charge, it's fine. This is fine. And yeah, charge is fine. And after grenade, and after that one. But then you need to... Yep! Apparently, charge isn't fine. He can actually do that exactly after a charge. Oh boy. How small the windows of actually attacking him are, like... Wait, no, he actually waited for that long. There's no consistency to this fight. Yeah, now he just teleported again. Okay, and yeah, he did that thing, sure. Okay, after that, you're gonna attack him, apparently. Okay, no. Okay, good. Okay. Whew. Okay. Not... Okay, yeah, sure. One HP off. Oof. Well, that was a one way to start a video. Kind of woke me up. Huh. Okay. And Contact Man. Mega Man Fusion Collab. Daibu Man. Mega Man Fusion. Have I played that one? I think I was an LP of it, maybe? It sounds really... Wait a minute. Is it a fan game? I mean, there are so many Mega Man fan games at this point that... Okay, this actually doesn't look familiar. But I guess we are given weapons at the start for some reason, because... Oh, and we have the Shiro version. That's a funny one to pronounce. Why would... that's just something I've never understood when people put the all the weapons at the start of the level, like, I guess you can make a... You can make the choice of, hey, you can actually play them... I mean, play the level without these weapons if you want to. But... okay. You can still never trust level maker, really. Like, there's no badges for the levels. Like, hey, you can play these without using... I mean, with Buster only, there's no, and you know, there's no, such tag doesn't exist yet, at least. I would really be glad if it did, but, well, I've actually talked about this so many times at this point, okay, and it was, yeah, a bit higher. Oh, I didn't even notice those at first, huh? Okay. I mean, yeah. This is overall a fine level, honestly, like a pretty... It feels kind of like a Wily States, to be honest. Okay. Oh. And the first checkpoint, I see. And yoga blocks? No? Oh, okay. They were just really late. Oh, two of them only. I mean, I guess, sir. There was... I mean... Huh. I just feel like that was more... just for the memes, I guess, the yoga blocks added there, like, hey, we can't make a level without yoga blocks, so let's just put two of them, slow the level down a little bit. Okay, and no, it was actually... Wait. Oh, God. Of course. Man, yeah, they were just there to introduce that, hey, yoga blocks are coming. That was the idea instead. I see. Oh no. I'm gonna keep this one at hand. Wait a minute, oh no. It's one of those. I actually haven't seen, I've been thinking like, oh, okay, sure. I was thinking, like, oh god, will there be spikes at the bottom there, but... Okay. Yeah. I'm max. Well, they gave me Skull Man, so... I almost died there. Okay. I'm not gonna stay there and wait for... Oh no. Oh, actually, this is fine, except they're out of sync, I think. Yeah, they're out of sync, I need to go back and come back again. Maybe they're now working? No. Now? Yeah, nope. Skull Man. I need to use the weapon called Skull Man. And, yeah. And then there's the problem of, okay, what do I actually cut? Because sometimes I think, I actually, without thinking, started talking about something relevant while I was going through, going through some tedious sections again. At least if I die repeatedly somewhere. I need to... Oh, noise. So I see. I basically need to wait for them. Or I can actually use Skullman, but they already showed that we're gonna have some company here, so it's gonna be really tough to actually kill those. Well, actually, we just had a checkpoint, so it's... Oh. Okay. Oh, far, those... things going even. When do they come back? How long is this section? Do they actually even come back? Because I started to think that when they go outside of the screen, what happens? I haven't experimented with those that much. I've only kept them in single screen like they are on Mega Man 2. I wonder if I'm screwed. Because it's really starting to feel like I am. Yeah. Okay. And then they would be... that would be just the worst if they suddenly would show up. Okay. I see. So, I'm gonna damage boost through. It actually hit... there? What? That was weird. Okay, let's just spam the Skull Man, I guess. And... hit and... oh no. Oh, good. I feel like, yeah, I mean, you can play through this without Skull Man, but, you know, like, it's almost... Yeah, it's all designed around not having Skull Man as a thing. Oh, I actually didn't even need to use it there. And then they keep ammo back. Wait a minute, do I need Skull Man for it? Oh wait, it's Crash Man time, everybody. So I can just use a Buster. Crash Man is pretty easy with a charge of... oh, never mind. Oh, it's Spark Man. I mean, where was the Crash Man's thing there? Or was it like, hey, that's the weakness. Crash Man, did you miss it? I think I did. Okay. I mean, this is an interesting idea for Spark Man. Spice it up a little bit, but I mean, it's still Spark Man. Even though I'm kind of getting beaten right now because this is really disorienting. Honestly, yeah. Especially when the bottom is kind of going both ways. So, yeah. Bit weird, okay. And I guess it's better to stay underneath him most of the time. It's better if he's on the top platforms and bottom, it feels like. Oh, I just need to keep the space bigger between me and him, maybe. Okay. And... yep. And... yep. Okay. Yeah. I mean, okay, that was pretty neat version, but... yeah, I've kind of come to the conclusion that what's the... like... other than making stuff like this, what's the point of having boss fights? Like, you can make combinations of them now, at least. And there are some... there have been some interesting boss fights, but... before you can actually make custom bosses... I don't know, what's the point of boss fights, mostly? Like, yeah, boss combos can be neat and all. But yeah, like, adding some custom scripts to the bosses, at least, like... I don't know, changing the patterns or something. I don't know, I mean, it would be really complicated to do, but yeah. Because quite often, they are just vanilla versions of them, and it's like, hey, we're gonna fight this boss now. I mean, I guess it's been... oh, it's one of these again. Oh, no, never mind, it's actually time... we have limited time. I see, oh, yikes. Okay. Sure, I mean, that's a neat idea, but... yeah. That was quite a timer there. Yeah. It could have been like a one more box kind of thing, you know, like you would have dropped out of the level at the end, and then actually two more boxes could have fitted there. I don't know, maybe. For this video I'm still gonna play the Grenade Man Reimagined. Let's see if this is just the level. I mean, is this the level or what? Okay. Oh, it's just the boss fight. Let's see. It sounds like it's the level. Okay. I have never played the original one, so let's see what the reimagined version is like. Oh boy. Yep. For some reason, I've seen Cutman reimagined the most. I don't even like Cutman's level that much. I mean, okay, it was the first one I ever played on Mega Man 1, so I have some connection to it, but yeah. First ever Mega Man level I actually played was Snake Man. Funnily enough, I still remember doing that. Wait a minute, so yeah, okay. Nice puzzle, I guess. Yep. Oh, whoa, I see. Yeah, I just need to kill these boys before they start messing up the place. I keep trying to do the headshots. I mean, I don't know, there's some satisfaction from doing that. Like, it's a pretty tight... Yeah, I wonder how the original one was. Because that one... not that good when it comes to design. Unfortunately. Please don't do that. Okay. Like, I already talked about the... you can play this with Buster Run attack, but yeah, the other attack I mentioned before would be you can play this without taking any damage. And of course, someone needs to do it in order to... like, the level uploader or someone who's played the level, I think anything would count as that. Like, you know, anything. I mean, yeah, it wouldn't have to be the uploader. Yeah, those would be really useful tags to have. Okay. Oh. Okay. And we have the easiest version of Grenade Man because we have infinite health, essentially. Let's see if I manage to beat the vanilla Grenade Man. Glitching around again, probably, in a minute. Okay. Oh. Honestly, I don't know, he's easier than the concrete boy, but yeah. Oh, of course, lasts for that long. Yeah. Okay. I mean, other than that one section where you were kind of forced to slide into the enemy and take damage, I think you were forced to take damage at least, because it had Mega Man 6 charge, so... there may be a way you could one-shot the enemy by just jumping and releasing at the right time when it's coming down. But I think you would still take damage from, like, I don't know. You'd have to actually make a level about it and try it multiple times if it's actually possible to kill it with Buster. Which, I mean, there were other weapons, of course. Which, I guess... yeah, when it's designed around having all the weapons, of course you can play it without taking damage. Yeah, I guess it's fine. Okay, well, I guess that was that for this time. So, my name is BeenFrozen, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!